We begin with President Trump tonight responding after coming under searing attack from two senators in his own party. The president was asked if he accepts any blame about the civility or lack thereof in politics and in Washington right now, how he answers that. And the president tweeting repeatedly about a standing ovation he received from Republican senators as proof they are not fractured. Here's ABC senior White House correspondent Cecilia Vega leading us off.
At the White House today, with his character under fire from fellow Republicans, President Trump brushed aside questions about whether it's time for him to be more civil.
Well, I think the press makes me more uncivil than I am. You know, people don't understand. I went to an Ivy League college. I was a nice student. I did very well. I'm a very intelligent person.
It comes in the wake of blistering attacks from two prominent Republican senators who are not running for re-election. Tennessee's Bob Corker accuses President Trump of debasing the country, and Arizona's Jeff Flake delivered this scathing rebuke on the Senate floor.
Reckless, outrageous, and undignified behavior has become excused and countenanced as telling it like it is.
Republicans say that politics in this country is in the gutter right now. Do you agree with that? Do you bear any responsibility for that?
I think it's sad, but I think to a large extent, in all due respect, I think the media causes a lot of it. But politics is a rough business. There's no question about it.
The president's message, everything is just fine. His party loves him. His proof? The standing ovation he received from Republican senators on Capitol Hill. He's now tweeted about it three times.
With Corker and Flake out, are there any other Republicans you want to see out of the Senate?
No, not at all.
Everybody in there is where they should be. No.
We have a very good relationship. Honestly, the Republicans are very, very well united.
Now he especially needs them to be united on tax reform. But his mixed messages on how to pay for those tax cuts frustrate even his own allies. The president has said definitively there will be no changes to your 401k. But today, the top Republican writing the tax plan said actually there could be changes, including limits on how much people can contribute to that retirement fund. When asked about that, the president said this.
401ks to me are very important, and they're important because that's one of the great benefits to the middle class.
But then just seconds later, a muddied message.
Well, maybe it is, and maybe we'll use it as negotiating, but I trust me.
So let's get to Cecilia Vega with us live tonight from the White House. And Cecilia, the president also spoke today about that ambush that killed four American special ops soldiers in Niger, saying for the first time that he did not specifically authorize their mission himself. And Cecilia, you asked the president about his phone call with the widow of one of those soldiers, Sergeant LaDavid Johnson. That widow saying the president didn't seem to know her husband's name. But the president strongly denied that. Here's how he answered you.
I respect her. I respect her family. I certainly respect LaDavid, who I, by the way, called LaDavid right from the beginning. Just so you understand, they put a chart in front. LaDavid says LaDavid Johnson. So I called right from the beginning. There's no hesitation. One of the great memories of all time. There was no hesitation.
Great memories, talking about the chart in front of him. Cecilia, the president seeming to question the widow's account.
He is, David, and Sergeant Johnson's wife said the president's phone call made her cry even more. But you heard him there. He's continuing to refute her account of this story. Today he said that, quote, all of these calls are about warmth and that nobody has more respect for these families than he does.